I'm joined by two people who are extremely sad. The first time I've seen Crouchy's team. Talk to me, what's happening after Wednesday?
Disappointing, let's be honest. No, I just felt it was Milan were there for the taking, you know. Like, you can go out all guns blazing, you know, don't go out without laying a glove on them, and that's what happened. Disappointing.
I mean, you did say, what's the point of getting top four? What is the point?
Yeah, I understand the financial, you know, benefits of getting in the top four, but if you're not going to have a go and you're going to go out in that manner and you're going to rest players in the FA Cup, you know, the fans want a trophy of some sort, or at least to have a go, and I think they just didn't get that at home.
You know what it is? Like, we're like you lot. You know, you just want a good run in the competition. Yeah. You're not going to win it. Like, we're not going to win a Champions League. You're not going to win a Champions League. But you just want those memorable moments, don't you?
You want, like, a big win away from home. And
you know what? No. Like, the fans want memories from the Champions League. When we had that campaign in the Champions League, if you ask the fans about it now, they'll go, what game can you remember? Yeah. They've got Inter Milan away, Bale hat-trick, Inter Milan at home, AC Milan at home. All the games were like, we were at it and we were on it. This campaign, I can't think of one good game of football I watched in the Champions League.
There's no memorable moments there at all.
Not one. There's not like big comebacks.
Well, neither
it's
can
not Richarlison, great performances.
I'm telling you, can't remember anything.
Well, there we go. I mean, and he's a player that's come out and spoken openly and honestly. And, you know, we arguably probably won't see him again whilst Conte's there.
Let's go and have a little look at these quotes, because it's strong words. You know, it feels very Spursy, if I'm honest, but that's just my opinion. this is what he had to say. If I'm honest, this season has been expletive. I want to play. I didn't understand Conte's choices. I was in a positive moment and Conte put me on the bench again. Yesterday, he tested me in the starting 11 and then bench again. Mm. Conte then responds with, he didn't criticise me. He said, my season is expletive. He is right. His season is not good because he had a lot of injuries. If he deserves to play, I'll give him the opportunity. It's fiery.
It is fiery. I have to say that I don't think Richarlison has pulled up any trees since arriving at Spurs at all. I think even when he's been given the opportunities, he hasn't really shone the way I would have liked to have seen him shine. But at the same time, Son has had his worst season at Spurs. And I personally would have liked to have seen Richarlison go in for like 10 games and then just see where he's at that point. Yeah, get a run and also maybe adapt the system slightly. Yeah. And I think that's one of Conte's big flaws. He doesn't have this ability to kind of go, okay, you know what? Let's maybe play 4-2-3-1 with Kane and Kane in behind Richarlison or something. It's all very samey and you're getting the same results, same performances. So I understand Richarlison's frustration, but it's a bit of both, if you know what I mean. He's not delivered, but he's also not been given the opportunity.
I would have liked to have seen Richarlison given a run of games. I don't feel like he's had a real run at it. Having said that, you know, you can't comment on a manager like that. You know, but I think the way it is, we all know Conte is most probably leave by the end of the season. You know, Richarlison's on a 4-year contract. You know, he knows that he can say something like that because he knows he's going to outstay the manager. I mean, that's plain for people to see.
You ever challenged a manager like that out in the open?
Not out in the open, definitely to his face.
Yeah.
And I think that's how things should be done. I think that's how things were probably more done in our day. You'd go knock on the gaffer's door and say, listen, I'm not happy about X, Y, and Z. But this is, he obviously feels like this is his last option. He's that frustrated about what he's seeing, his whole experience so far in a Spurs shirt, that he's just thought, you know what, I'm going to do what I'm doing. And if I'm totally honest, it always happened with the foreign players, didn't it? Whenever they went away on international duty, whoever it was with, they'd speak to their local press, and then that was it. Like, our press would get hold of it. It'd be big, big news. And so it doesn't surprise me. But, yeah, in my day, it would be more I'd be knocking on the gaffer's door.
Do you know what? Glenn said it, I think, when we did the game. And he was like, well, you've got England's, you know, number 9, number 10, and you've got Brazil's number 9, right? And how can you not make that work?
Like, it's true.
You know, if you look at it, you think... You know, come on, I think, if in all honesty, I think Richarlison probably deserves a run of games. And I understand his frustration, but I don't agree with this coming out in the press and talking about it like that.
But it also goes back to who's bought him then.
Yeah, if he's not a Conte player.
If Conte's not bought this guy, which it doesn't seem that way, then that's why this is happening. Same with Jed Spence. So you haven't got this synergy already between your manager and the ownership. Daniel Levy seems to be the one that's brought in Richarlison, probably on the back of everybody saying for years, we need somebody to back up Kane.
Yeah.
And then you bring in a manager who goes, well, I don't really want to play him. What's the point?
Win. You can't win as a player or a club owner or a manager. You can't win.
You've got a big smile on your face.
I know, yeah.
I win. I don't know.
I know, yeah. You can't win. We're top of the league.
We want to go to see what the fans are saying, all right? Because it's not just me.
Yeah, go.
It's not just me. First tweet. Guys, this is so Spursy. Just that one. That was me. That was tweeted 5 minutes ago. Ham Tottenham. He's made the situation worse. Uncontrollable. Players may be unhappy, but using social media is not the right way. He should have talked with Conte behind closed doors. And that kind of mirrors exactly what you say. It should stay inside the dressing room because it creates a toxic atmosphere. And I guess you've got, it's almost like Lord of the Flies. You've got certain players are on the manager's side. Certain players are kind of on Richarlison's.
You can either create unity and strength, or you can create chaos
against the world,
and mayhem.
Right,
yeah, and he's gone the other way. Yeah,
that makes sense. All right, I'm going to go grab a few more tweets because people are very interested. It's BT's very own Reshmane Chowdhury. Tonight aside, prioritising trophies and a full rebuild should have happened under Poch. Success on the pitch and building a winning mentality. I really respect the business model, but in my opinion, football comes first. The rest would have followed. Back to square one. And then we're going to go to Piercy, who's written, I've never felt as connected to a manager as I did to Poch. He's got us with him. We've got him. I still have his pick as my screensaver on my personal and my job phone.
Yeah.
Bring him home. We're going to mash those two up into one. Is Poch part of this rebuild that needs to happen? Do you see Poch coming back? Is it the right idea? Because you guys were happy to see him go.
Oh, listen, I think
we're happy to see him go.
We all love him as a manager, I think, you know, but the squad is very different to the one he had. I look at, like, defensively, even, you know, Alderweireld, you know, Vertonghen, Rose, Walker, like, it's a huge rebuild needed, I think, you know, player-wise. But also, I think coming back doesn't always work. Some of the best memories have been in recent history with Spurs. I've been under Pochettino. We all love him as a manager, but...
You take that.
I'm not sure. You know, coming back to this squad of players, which is not as good as the one he had, and it ended, you know, quite badly for him. And I think there's other managers out there that can come in. Like, Tuchel is someone who is out there at the moment, available... who's a top class manager, and he'll be snapped up very soon.
Yeah, I like Brendan Rodgers as well, by the way, another manager that I think would do very well. Just quickly on the Poch situation, it all comes down to whether they're going to support him. They didn't support him.
It comes to the ownership down, right? And this has been the same problem for every Spurs manager for the last...
He delivered over and above and beyond, basically. Yeah. You know, Champions League football, Champions League finals, didn't sign any players for about 3 or 4 windows.
Yeah.
And when that moment came to kind of really crack on, they didn't back him, which is why it fell apart. I would take him back also.
You take him back? Interesting.
I would take him back.
It's out there for the world to see now.
Yeah, Poch knows I love him. You know, as that. He's a loved man in at Tottenham. And I did a chat with him, I remember, in lockdown for BT Sport.
Yeah.
And this was only about a year after he'd left. And he categorically said there and then, I see myself back at Tottenham at some point. So that was great to hear. And I would love to see him back.
In this current climate, though, it feels like there's a real lack of patience. There's you know, it feels like managers are now getting less and less time. You see Scott Parker sacked after 12 games, stuff like that. Do you really want to go into a club at Tottenham that has perennially underperformed or maybe over?
Who are you talking about here, though? Poch?
But any manager, is that Tottenham job a little bit of a poison chalice?
The only person that I've heard in this conversation where you would... If I was him and I'd be thinking, do I take that job or not, would probably be Thomas Tuchel. Because Thomas Tuchel, in my opinion, is top level. He could probably go to Real Madrid, could go to any a club of his choosing.
Yeah.
The rest, I think it didn't work out for Poch at PSG, and I think he's still got a point to prove. I think Brendan Rodgers has had his little go at Liverpool and, you know, took a step back with Leicester, had huge success at Celtic, obviously, but it would be a step in the right direction, I would feel. who was the other one you mentioned? It was Tuchel, Brendan Rodgers, wasn't it? And Poch, that was it. Yeah, I think those few are, you know, Poch in particular and Brendan would be a step in the right direction for their careers.